Hello, everyone. Again, another episode with Liz Soria, your tax advisor and your QuickBooks certified provisor. I have decided today that because so many people have been asking me about what's the difference between, an estimate versus to an invoice and a sales receipt in QuickBooks Online, that, and obviously also a desktop, doesn't matter, it's just an accounting terminology, to just give you a clear definition. So allow me to start with the number one. First things that we normally do as we engage with a prospect client is to create a what we call an estimate. At least inside QuickBooks, that's the only option you have. Now, many of you probably have heard the terminology, give me a quote, give me a proposal. Some of these proposals also comes with a legal agreement or a service agreement or contract, depending the type of service or product that you're selling. However, the majority will probably end up first in an estimate. And why an estimate? Because you want to be able to give a whole picture to your customer of what their investments is going to be for them to completely hire your services or to buy your products, right? So the very first thing we need to do within QuickBooks is create an estimate. So if you know this is not a existing client and they need to have that, whether because maybe of a bidding circumstance, right? Because a lot of people, they have to get estimates. It's better before you create that invoice that you put it as an estimate. Second reason for that is because in QuickBooks, when you record an estimate, it is a non-posting transaction. So let me say that again, non-posting transaction. So you probably, some of you might be wondering, some of you might know already, but if you don't, it's very simple. It means that it's not gonna really affect your general ledger. It's not gonna affect your accounts receivable. That's right. So you're gonna be able to create an estimate of several estimates to depending how many prospect clients you got, right? And just, you can go ahead and email those out. Not only you look very nice and professional, but at least you have something on writing, okay? Now, hopefully if that prospect client becomes, and converts to being a customer, then at that point, it's very easily within QuickBooks just to go ahead and convert that estimate into a invoice, which is great because it's gonna save you time. So instead of having to retype all the data again, you can just with one simple click, transfer it, and it says there that if you go into the estimate sections of QuickBooks Online, you click on that and then it will show you an option where it can be created as an invoice. Very simple, okay? Now, the second step, which I think is very important, is the difference with sales receipt. So what's the difference between an invoice and a sales receipt? Pretty much they're very much alike. What I like to see is sales receipt more if for someone who's doing a instant transaction. And what do I mean by that? Well, let's say for an example, I buy from you a service or a product and I pay you now, right now. So in that case, you don't need to bill me because I'm already paying you instantly, right? So that's the same thing as, let's put an example. You go to a store and when you go and do your shopping, you put your credit card, right? Or you're paying cash, whatever it might be. If that's the case, then what happens? Automatically, what do you get from the merchant? You get a sales receipt. So that's really the big difference. Now, if you have a client or customer that you have to bill, then you wanna create an invoice in QuickBooks, and that's gonna allow you to actually put in it terms. So for an example, maybe you allow them to pay you in 7 days or 15 days or 30, 60, 90, whatever might be your net terms or the agreement that you have specifically with that customer, right? Because we can have different net terms for different customers, depending if they've been, paying you on time, and perhaps you might be one of those, businesses that you prefer prepayment. Hey, give you a thumbs up. Get, you know, try to collect your money up front, and that's wonderful, right? Or maybe at least you can get, you know, a retainer, a deposit. So it's the same thing. So again, sales receipts is for like instant sales. All right. And invoices really is what's called accrued basis, which means it's for the future. Okay. So I hope that this video has helped a little bit on, you know, definition, especially while you're using QuickBooks. And I'm hoping to create some short videos in how to actually record the transactions in QBO, as we call it, and go step by step. And possibly what I'm gonna do, instead of using the actual software, I think would be more beneficial where I can actually show you in snapshots, okay, of the images. That way you don't get too distracted while moving around the cursor. It would be easier, I think, for even anyone to learn. So once again, this is Liz Soria with ETVS. I am your tax advisor, your QuickBooks accounting consultant, and stay in touch with me. Remember to like, share, and comment. It really helps a lot to grow my channel here on YouTube. And also for those of you who are listening to me through directly through my podcast at soundcloud.com, you can always find me there at Tax Advisory and Biz Coach Success Podcast. Okay? Thank you so much, folks. And until next time, I wish you the best. And like I said, any questions you have, so go ahead and shoot me a message. Let me know what else you think might be something that you want me to bring up on the next video or topic. I'm here as much as you to learn, you know, what my audience really needs. So interaction is extremely important. Thank you, guys, and I hope you have a great, great time and great day. Bye-bye. Take care, Liz.